This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hi there, welcome to episode 1, The Order of Operations. In this episode, we're going to give you a rather strange looking fraction, and we're going to have you simplify it into something nicer using the order of operations. Let's get started. So that the fraction I've given you is kind of a large one. We have 5 squared minus 4 squared, in parentheses, squared, divided by 9 over 3, plus 1. If you run into something that's this complicated looking, and it has a division bar in the middle, it's a good idea to rewrite, first, the division bar as a regular old division sign. That can help clear some of the confusion up almost immediately. Let's try it. So we still have 5 squared minus 4 squared, and now a division sign, and then 9 divided by 3 plus 1. This 5 squared minus 4 squared came from the top, and the 9 divided by 3 came from the bottom. Let's go ahead and add some parentheses to the bottom part, just so we can remember that whole thing was the bottom. Now that we've got it all written out nicely, let's follow the order of operations. You might have heard of PEMDAS before. The P stands for parentheses, E stands for exponents, M and D stand for multiplication and division, A and S stand for addition and subtraction. So let's begin by doing our operations that are in parentheses before we do anything else. So let's do our exponents first. We have 5 squared minus 4 squared in this first parentheses. Well, 5 squared is just 25, and 4 squared is just 16, and the rest of it stays the same for the moment. We are not going to operate that 2 right here yet. We're going to hold off on that until we do everything that's in the parentheses first. The rest of the equation stays the same, and that takes care of our exponents. Now let's move on to the multiplication and division part. Well, we're not going to touch that division sign, that's not in parentheses, but we are going to use this division sign, that is in parentheses. 9 over 3 gives us just 3, and the rest of the equation still stays the same. Like this. And that takes care of our multiplications and divisions. Let's move on to our additions and subtractions. Well, we have a subtraction in this parentheses, 25 minus 16. 25 minus 16 is just 9, and the rest of the equation stays the same. 9 divided by 3 plus 1. Now we'll carry that forward into step 3. With this expression, we're just going to now repeat the order of operations for anything that is not in parentheses. We begin again with exponents. We have 9 raised to the second power, which is just 9 times 9, and 9 times 9 is 81, divided by 3, plus 1. Now we do any multiplications and divisions. Well, we have a division right here, 81 divided by 3, which is 27. Still plus 1. That takes care of our multiplications and divisions. And then we do any additions or subtractions that remain. We'll just do our 27 plus 1, which gives us 28. And that is our final answer. So, just to recap, in order to condense really complicated looking fractions, the best thing to do is just try to rewrite them as a division, and then just follow your standard order of operations. Exponents, then multiplication and division, then addition and subtraction. Always make sure you do your parentheses operations before you do anything outside the parentheses. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you next episode.